materials came, and I wasn't interested in bright, shiny buildings. I was interested in buildings that were somewhere between being whole and disappearing through kind of decay and entropy. So the life is filled with both. You're growing and you're decaying. Now that I'm my age, I can tell you my theory was right. They happen at the same time. I'm still learning and growing, but I'm also decaying at a rapid rate. Very important, three qualities. One of them was that they have no meaning, predetermined. They're meaningless. They have no purpose, okay, predetermined. They don't have a function. And the third is that they're difficult to occupy. This is really maybe the most important one. So you can't comfortably go in them and resume your usual habits. Because you're going to have to stand up on the floors, you know. And you have to figure out how to be in the space. You have to invent. And I call these free spaces. Free in the sense that they were free of those things. They were free of meaning and free of purpose. Certainly free of comfort. So you couldn't bring your own furniture in, so to speak. You had to invent the way to be in them. And of course, the underlying premise of my idea was, well, that's the way all space should be. We should approach every space as potentially a free space, but we have to invent how to be in it and not follow the typological model given to us by all the people around us, by all the institutions that commission and build buildings, build spaces. We should just invent who we are and what we do in those spaces. Earthquake's going to shake things up, if earthquake is going to shift the earth and like tectonic plates, why can't, you know, it build space for us? Why can't this shift and change actually be a construction and reconstruction of space? Yeah, space we don't know how to behave in, but we can learn. Now, that's the most important, that we have to get involved. So when Sarajevo was under attack, I had to get involved. I had to get involved as an architect, because that's what I knew how to do. So I had to take my skills. If I'd been a doctor, I could have taken those skills. But just to, you know, stand and watch it happen. So there's a moral dimension there, too, you see. So, you're right. It's present.